here we got a Dune Runner in his box, looking good. Always beautiful art from Fast Choice. Not a lot of accessories to this guy, but he is good looking, very cool. We all know about the misprint they did there. It's unfortunate that they don't give you the gold hand or any of the little birds or anything, but it's fine. The toy's badass by itself. Let's go ahead and take a look at him. And here he goes. Dune Rider. And he is well made. Heavy, nice, solid, good toy. It's kind of plain. I kept these little shields on them here. I got the Autobot sticker under there. Maybe you can see it right here. So when he's in his little dune buggy mode, he has the Autobot symbol there. This thing is very clean. Super awesome clean. Let's go ahead and throw out some of his, some of Fantoy's latest offerings. We'll start off with Sea Spray. There he goes. And I think that looks pretty good. I know they got the fat little Sea Spray coming out, but I'm thinking I'm going to pass on that one. Let's go ahead and throw in Warpath. And all three of these toys right here, well, four when I bring out Braun next. Matter of fact, we'll just go ahead and put them on now. All four of these toys are well made, solid toys, solid. Braun has posability issues, Beachcomber does too. Sea Spray is really good, posable. So is Warpath, is very posable. But Warpath is not really fun to transform. The Beachcomber is fun. Let's go ahead and get them transformed into their op modes and see what they're looking like. And here we got them transformed. And I love the blue headlights on them. I think that looks good. His front wheels are unstable. They don't stay in or out whenever. They don't have a locking point in there or anything. But I can live with it. I love the rubber tires. I love the chrome wheels. This thing is good. This thing is well made. It's very cool. I dig the inside of it. You can see the steering wheel, little dials in the front. You can see the little stick to shift the gears, emergency brake, little motor back there. This thing is good. It's very good. I'm excited about it. I didn't have the X-Transbot. I was using the Hasbro Power of the Primes as a fill-in. And I think this is a diecast. It feels cold, but anyways, I went with the sticker here in the front. I think that for me that works. I don't know for you guys, but for me that works. But if you don't like it, you can go with that or no sticker, or if you want to put the sticker and you can not see him transform in robot mode, you can use these, which I'm doing. Let's go ahead and throw out some of his counterparts. This is Fast Toys' latest offerings. We'll start off with Sea Spray. It was first. And Sea Spray has a lot of, his feet are very heavy. Diecast and his feet are very heavy. And I think that looks very good. You can stick his gun up there. And then we'll go ahead and throw in Braun. And that's pretty cool as well. I like to wear rubber tires and the wheels. And I dig the color. Some people weren't happy with the color, but I was. Let's go ahead and slide him here, and we'll throw in Warpath. One thing I can tell you about these toys is that they're all well made. Limited posability, very posable, a lot of die cast, very good posability. Transformation is but let's go ahead and see these guys in for the parting shot. And here we got them, parting shot. And I think this looks good. I think the scaling is good. Looking forward to the triple changer, Blitzwing and Astro Train that are coming in. Jazz, Mirage. So. Here we go. All are one.